Let's move on now to the idea of mutually exclusive events. Two events are said to be mutually exclusive if the occurrence of one precludes, or in other words, prevents, the occurrence of the other. So in other words, they're mutually exclusive if you know that if one happens, the other cannot happen or could not happen, absolutely did not happen. As an example, let event A be we observe a male, and event B be we observe a female. A and B are mutually exclusive. You can't pull one person out of a group and they're both male and female. Not messing with Mother Nature. I mean, just generally we have males and females. Okay, so let's apply this idea to this table of class standing and employment that we've looked at before. Now, I want to consider the event freshman and identify at least one event that is mutually exclusive and explain why it's mutually exclusive. Well, if we look at the event observe a freshman, it's right here. So what we need to do is find an event, at least one event, that is mutually exclusive. Well, it can't be any of these events. If I were to use, say, 5 to 10, that would be right here, they share a 12. So freshman and 5 to 10 can happen at the same time. But notice that sophomore does not overlap with freshman. So sophomore and freshman are mutually exclusive. Actually, so is junior and freshman and senior and freshman. In a table, all columns will actually be mutually exclusive of each other. I can't be a freshman and a sophomore, a freshman and a junior, a freshman and a senior. Likewise, all rows will also be mutually exclusive of each other. I can't claim to work 5 to 10 hours and more than 20, as an example. So the reason that these are mutually exclusive is because they do not share any outcomes. If I told you I chose a person randomly from this group and they were in fact a freshman, that immediately eliminates all these possibilities. Now I want to pick an event that is not mutually exclusive and explain why it's not mutually exclusive. Well, again, we're dealing with freshmen. And any event that has something in common will not be mutually exclusive. Less than 5. That is not mutually exclusive because they share 24 outcomes. There are 24 freshmen that were both, or 24 people that were both freshmen and they reported working less than 5 hours. Actually, any row would not be mutually exclusive because each row shares something. So again, if two events are mutually exclusive, if one happens, the other can't. If they're not mutually exclusive, if one happens, the other could. Doesn't mean it did. It means it could happen. Another quick example would be tossing coins. So if I toss a single coin, I could get, the sample space would be a head and a tail. These are two different events. That's one event, that's another event. These two are mutually exclusive of each other. I can't flip a single coin and get both a head and a tail. It's not going to happen. I can get a head or I can get a tail. End of story. They're mutually exclusive. Another quick, obvious example would be course grades. Well, in this course, you get an F, you could get a D, you could get a C, you could get a B, or you could get an A. These are mutually exclusive of each other. You cannot get an A and also get a C in the course. You end up with one course grade. So these would be mutually exclusive of each other. Now if I put this same idea into a table, maybe I put, grades. I go A, B, C, D, and F. And then over here, I'm going to say, how about males and females? Well, again, males and females will be mutually exclusive of each other. They won't share anything. The grades will be mutually exclusive of each other, but any individual grade would not be mutually exclusive of the gender, because they could share a value here. I don't actually have values to put in there. This is just a for instance. So you can hopefully you can help better help you see what's going on with the concept of being mutually exclusive.